In this problem, we're asked to write an exponential function that passes through the points 0, 800, and 3, 6.4. We also want to determine what the exponential growth or decay rate is and find the function value when x equals 1. For an exponential function in this form here, the base b is equal to 1 plus r, where r is the exponential growth or decay rate expressed as a decimal. A is the initial value or function value when x equals 0, and x is the exponent. So looking at the given information about our function, if the function contains the point 0, 800, this means that f of 0 must equal 800, or 800 is the value of A, or the initial value. If the function contains the point 3, 6.4, then this means f of 3 is equal to 6.4. To emphasize that the initial value, or a, is equal to 800, we could substitute 0 for x into our exponential function, which would give us a times b to the 0 power must equal 800, and b to the 0 is equal to 1, therefore a is equal to 800. So using a equals 800 and the second function value, we can now determine the value of b, our base. So now we'll substitute 3 for x and set the function value equal to 6.4. But we also know a is equal to 800, so we have the equation 800 times b to the third power must equal 6.4. So now we'll isolate b to the third by dividing both sides by 800. So we have b to the third must equal 6.4 divided by 800. And now we can take the cube root of both sides of the equation, or we could raise both sides to the 1/3 power. Let's go ahead and do that. So on the left side here, we would multiply the exponents. 3 times 1/3 is 1, so we have b on the left side. And we'll evaluate this on the calculator. So we'll have 6.4 in parentheses divided by 800. We're going to raise this to the 1/3 power, which again is the same as taking the cube root. So b is equal to 0.2, or 2/10. Which means the exponential function that passes through the given two points is f of x equals 800 times 0.2 raised to the power of x. To check this, we can go ahead and graph this function to make sure it passes through these two points. So the function is graphed in blue. Notice how it does pass through the two given points. Therefore, our exponential function is correct. But we're also asked to determine the exponential growth or decay rate and the function value when x equals 1. We can see from our function values, as x increases, the function values are going down. So we do have exponential decay, which means r should be negative. Since our base b is equal to 1 plus r, in this case, we would have the equation 0.2 must equal 1 plus r. So we would subtract 1 on both sides. So r is equal to negative 0.8, which as a percentage would be 80%. And because it's negative, we know we have exponential decay. So the exponential decay rate is 80%. We don't include the negative here because we already said it was exponential decay. So what this means is, each time x increases by 1, the function value decreases by 80%. Now I want to make the connection between the exponential decay rate and the base of our exponential function. Notice how the base is 0.2. So every time x increases by 1, we multiply by another factor of 0.2, which means that the function value is decaying or decreasing by 80%. As x increases by 1, it's retaining 20% of the value each time x increases by 1. And now for the last question, we want to determine the function value when x equals 1. So we want to evaluate f of 1, which is going to be equal to 800 times 0.2 to the first, which is equal to 160. And that's going to do it for this example. I hope this was helpful.